Welcome to Professor Mad, Electronics for Everyone. Today, we are going to talk about transistors. Transistors are one of the most important inventions of the 20th century. Because of the transistors, we are able to build much faster, much smaller, and very energy-efficient controller circuits at a very low cost. Your computer or mobile phone consists of microprocessors and ICs, which contain billions of transistors. The transistor is a three-terminal solid-state device that can do two different jobs. It can work either as an amplifier or a switch. There are two basic types of transistors out there, bipolar junction or BJT, and metal-oxide field effect or MOSFET. In this tutorial, we'll focus on the BJT because it's slightly easier to understand. The bipolar junction transistors or BJTs are divided into two groups, NPN and PNP. The circuit symbols for both the NPN and PNP BJTs are like this. The pins are labeled collector C, base B, and emitter E. The only difference between the symbols of NPN and PNP is the direction of the arrow on the emitter. The arrow on an NPN points out, and on the PNP, it points in. In NPN transistors, one P-type semiconductor layer is sandwiched between the two N-type semiconductor layers. In PNP transistors, one N-type semiconductor layer is sandwiched between the two P-type semiconductor layers. In NPN transistors, the current flows from the collector terminal to the emitter terminal. In PNP transistors, the current flows from the emitter to the collector terminal. We use transistors for two purposes: as a switch and as an amplifier. Let's talk about how to use a transistor as a switch. A switch is a device we use to power on and off a load. We are all familiar with mechanical switches. We can change the states of the switch and power on and off the load as we need. We can use the transistor for the same purpose. Instead of moving mechanical parts, the transistor turns on using an electrical signal. The switching happens between the collector and emitter terminal. Under normal conditions, there is a high resistance between the collector and emitter terminals, so the transistor acts as an off switch. But when we apply a plus 0.7 volts to the base junction of an NPN transistor, the resistance between the emitter and collector terminal becomes zero. It acts as an on switch. Likewise, we can control the switching action using the electric signal applied to the base terminal. Unlike mechanical switches, transistors do not contain moving parts, so we call those solid-state switches. Hence, transistors are more durable and can have very high switching frequencies. Can you turn on and off a mechanical switch 100 times per second? Even if we manage to do that, how long will it last at such speed? But we can switch transistors more than 1 billion times per second. And more importantly, we can contain billions of these transistors in a small chip. This is a simple example of a transistor switch circuit. A rain detector. We can use two separate conductor plates as the rain sensor. In dry conditions, no current flows through it, since the voltage of the base terminal is 0 volts. So the transistor is at off state. The buzzer makes no sound. When water droplets hit the sensing pad, it becomes wet, and the water allows a little current from it to be. This tiny current will be enough to increase the potential of the base terminal to 0.7 V. Then the transistor will saturate, and the buzzer will turn on. When an NPN transistor is used as a switch, if we set the base to 0 volts, it acts as an off switch. We call this cutoff mode. If we set the base to 0.7 volts, then it acts as an on switch. We call this saturate mode. We can use transistors as amplifiers. Some of the most powerful transistor applications involve amplification, turning a low power signal into one of a higher power. When it works as an amplifier, it takes in a tiny electric signal with almost no energy at one end and produces a much bigger copy at the other end. In other words, it's a kind of power booster. Amplifiers can increase the voltage or current of a signal, taking something from the microvolt or microampere range and converting it to a more useful high power level. Transistor amplifiers are useful in things like hearing aids. A hearing aid has a tiny microphone in it that picks up sounds from the world around you and turns them into fluctuating electric currents. These are fed into a transistor that boosts them and powers a tiny loudspeaker, so you hear a much louder version of the sounds around you. That's all for today. Thank you for watching us. Like and subscribe Professor Mad for more educational videos. Don't hesitate to comment your thoughts.